All right, so we are recording. So today we are talking with Kelly White of SheLearnsVideo.com. Now, Kelly and I go back, I think, probably to 4 or 5 years ago. So she's a photographer and videographer in Indianapolis, which is where I am from. So we've known each other for a while, but she is amazing at video. And she has this new education platform, SheLearnsVideo.com, where she is teaching photographers how to shoot video. So today we'll be talking about the beginning basics of how to start shooting video, how to tie it into your messaging, and how to share that online. All right, so Kelly, I'll go ahead and hand it over to you. While she's talking, guys, if you have any questions, go ahead and drop them in the chat box, and we will have a Q&A section at the end. All right, so let's go ahead and get started.
All right. Well, thanks, Keely. I appreciate the intro. It's always fun to connect with a friend again, and this seems like a great way to do it. So yes, I am based in Indianapolis, and I'm a family and newborn photographer and filmmaker, and then I also do custom films for small business owners. And kind of along the path of learning video myself, I really felt like there was a lack of video education for especially female filmmakers and female photographers looking to kind of break into the video space. And so that's kind of my specialty at this point, is just helping to encourage other female business owners and female photographers who are looking to add video. And so, yeah, that's SheLearnVideo.com, and I'll talk a little bit more about it at the end. But the two topics I really want to chat about today, I think the best way to break them out is just into kind of these two genres. And the first one is to how to start expanding and using video for your business and your website. And then the other one is how to get started in crafting the videos and creating an impactful video message for your brand. So those are kind of the things we're going to cover. And I'm just really excited to be here with you guys today. Okay, so starting to use video for your brand and on your website. So the first few things, I think, when I was getting started with video, especially when I was just adding it into my business and not necessarily looking to shoot films for other business owners, was just, you know, how do I create videos? What's the most impactful way to do that? And you know, what process was I going to use to go about it? So I think I wanted to start out by asking, and you can comment and I'll look through it in a moment, but if you are using video in your business, where are you utilizing the video? And even if you're rewatching this, definitely leave a comment. I would love to just know, you know, if you're already using video, are you doing it on Instagram stories, Facebook lives? And I really feel that if you aren't doing any type of video content at all, that social media is a great place to get started. With Keely hosting the Facebook Lives and then now doing it through Zoom, I just think it's a really fun and interactive way to encourage your clients to get involved in whatever process that might be. And I'll talk a little bit about the best steps you can use for your specific business to educate through video, to share kind of the day in the life of your business, different content, and how that can work really well for you. So social media, if you're not already doing it, is definitely one way. And then I wanted to kind of start out by saying that I feel like video marketing can take so many different forms. So you can have kind of what I call explainer videos, where you're maybe introducing yourself, introducing your services or your products. With that, you could also do like a presentation video where you're showing physical products. I know, Keely, you do a lot of physical products with the people that you photograph as far as selling those, and many photographers do prints and albums. So you could go through that in a video format. A day in the life of your business, like I said, kind of do your own behind the scenes vlog. You could do tutorials. So how-to content works really well. I know a lot of photographers are kind of already writing how-to blogs on their website. So just throwing a video in there to make it pop even more. And we'll talk a little bit more about how that'll additionally drive traffic to your website. Customer testimonials can be great on video, interviews with other people in your industry who you're trying to connect with. You could do live streams, you could pre-record the video. So there's just so many different options when it comes to video content. And I think what I would encourage you to do is to sit down and kind of write out a list of the things you're already doing in your business and how you could integrate video within those things. So if you have time over the next few days and after the session, take some time to think of ways your video can utilize business or your business can utilize video. And one way I like to start out with is just an introduction video, whether you do that through social media or you do something a little bit more formal, tours of your office, answering client questions, and recycling blog posts with video content. So for example, I know a lot of you are photographers. So one example I was thinking of this morning is that if you already have a blog on maybe great venues in your area where you have shot weddings before, you already have images to share. So why not create a video slideshow, just drop some images in and do a little voiceover about each venue, why you loved it. And you could apply this to kind of anything. It doesn't have to necessarily be venues, but it will give that blog post additional content in a video. It will give you more opportunities to share that same content, and you're kind of recycling it. It's super shareable because the venues will love it. They might even share it. So it's getting you more connected with other people in your industry, and it's expanding on something you have essentially already created. Okay, and then another thing is to do a review on a product. I know a lot of people who are just starting out in photography sometimes reach out to other photographers and say, hey, you know, what cameras are you using or what lenses do you like or what's in your bag? I just recently did a video on all the gear I have in my bag and I just sat down and kind of popped through, you know, these are the microphones I use and this is the camera that I utilize. So it's really simple and really easy. And once you can get yourself comfortable on screen, it's a nice way to add that personality in to your messaging and just really build up that kind of like, know, and trust factor that your clients are looking for from you, no matter kind of where you're at in your business. It's always important to be building that with your clients and potential clients. All right. So I know I'm answering questions at the end, but if you think of anything from what I'm saying, please throw it in there. I do see something about a GoPro, which I'm excited. I'll definitely talk about that. Oh, and TikTok. Yeah, there we go. I love it. I also saw Instagram today when I went on has added some new little format. I'll have to look at what it is and write a comment, but I think Instagram's maybe trying to take over TikTok. I don't know, but video is like all the rage. So, okay. Connecting video to your message. So I know Keely talked a lot about this, and I really think that this is a great way to take the message that you already want to get out to people, that you're already typing out on your about page, and put it in a new format. And a format that really gets your face and your personality in front of people. So I think the best way to start connecting to your message through video is to really think about your current business and start looking at all of the things you're already doing. What do you offer? What experience do you provide? And what are common questions that you get asked or perhaps common, blog themes or blog posts that you've written? And then break those down into videos. You know, small videos, whether they're featuring slideshow images from sessions you've done, or if they are featuring you, you know, looking directly at the camera or showing off your gear. I think those are all different ways to kind of connect what you're already doing and your message to a video. I think showing the experience you provide and what you offer to clients, sometimes that's going to take a little bit more advanced video shooting. And we'll talk a little bit more in a second about whether I think you should try and do all of this on your own or if you should outsource it. I do think that there are opportunities for both. And I think you should perhaps be doing both depending on what type of budget you have, or perhaps teaching yourself to shoot video and make it look kind of that higher level, higher quality. Okay, I've also found a bunch of links, and I can drop these in the Facebook page afterwards, but just showing different statistics on video. And the statistics are really overwhelming. I mean, at this point, especially depending on what age demographic you're targeting, but if you're targeting younger people, they would much rather watch video content on the internet than read your blog post or, you know, look at just your pictures. So if you've got it in a video format, they're probably going to be more inclined to view it. Studies show that 54% of consumers want to see more video content from a brand or a business that they support. So, you know, over half of people want to come and see your video content. And the people who maybe didn't answer that way, I think sometimes they don't even know what they're looking for, because video is so attractive to people. It's so easy to go on a website and click play. It's fun to view. It's easy to view. And I just think that it's a great way to get yourself in front of your audience in perhaps a different way than your competitors, or a different way than you've done in the past. And it's just a great way to serve your clients. So for me, I think one big way, even if you decide, okay, I don't really want to make a bunch of informational videos, I don't really want to show off my face too often, I think using it for client relations is a really important step that we can all take to build a better, more impactful, personalized, unique relationship with our clients. And it's something that, for example, if you get an email from a client and they ask maybe 5 to 10 questions about their session, you know, some people just have a lot of questions. How much easier would it be to respond with a quick, simple video personalized for them than it would be to spend like an hour writing out an email? For me, it's a lot easier to just pop on a tool that I'll show you here in just a minute and easily craft a custom response for them. So the tool I really like for client relations and quick videos, that sometimes I use these to walk clients through galleries, through payment questions, ordering options. You could do QuickTime. I know QuickTime like allows you to screen record and you can kind of quickly edit off of that. Another option I really like is called Loom. It's loom.com. And I have used it in the past. You can, let me see. Can I share my screen, Keely, maybe?
You should be able to share your screen. So let me know if you've been any issues with that.
Yeah, it says host disabled attendee screen sharing. I can just drop a little, maybe I'll make you guys a Loom and drop it in the Facebook after this to kind of walk you through it. But if you go to loom.com, I know they'll have plenty of little tutorials, but basically you can walk your clients through any questions they might have or anything that you want to share, and then you can send them a link directly to the video. So it's super simple, super personalized, really custom. It's not something you have to upload to YouTube and make public to the whole world. You could, but this is a really cool tool to do it.
The Kelly, other thing, are you, sorry, real quick, are you still unable to share your screen?
Let me see. Ooh, here we go. Okay.
Nice.
Okay. Let's see. Google Chrome. Desktop one. There we go. Just one quick second here, friends. Okay. Can you see my screen? Okay. So here is what my Loom looks like on the back end. And just kind of for lack of a better example, I'm going to click on this video. I did a preschool photography for a local preschool here in Indianapolis. And instead of having 175 parents email me and say, I can't figure out the password, or I need help finding my child's gallery. I made one video and sent it to all the families. I walk them through how to order. And honestly, it cut down on questions. I had like maybe 3 questions with 175 parents. Like, that's unbelievable. So I really think video helps. You can see how many views, like 50 people watched or 59 people watched it. It made it easy for me to just share the link with the director of the school and get it out there to families. So if I click play here.
Thrive Preschool last week. I am very excited to share all of this.
Does it sound okay?
To check back to the gallery if you have.
Okay. So yeah, it's just a super easy way to kind of walk through things for your clients or your families. Let me see here if I can stop it.
If you have multiple children who attend.
Here we go. Okay. Does anyone else hate hearing their own voice on video? Like, I'm fine making the videos, but I don't really want to watch them back. I know. It's something we all have to get over because you sound fine to everyone else. It's just you that it bothers. Okay. So Loom, cool tool. Check it out. QuickTime, which, you know, in screen recording, there's lots of different ways to do it, but I do really like it for client relations. And I think outside of social media, when you're just starting to dabble in video, it can be a fun tool to play around with. So really cool and a good way to serve people. So using video on your website, I know Keely has talked about this, and it is really important when it comes to the copy on your website and the content that you're sharing. But one main reason to use video on your website, which goes hand in hand with great copy and valuable content, is creating content that will boost your SEO. So anytime you can get your SEO going up, it's good. Google cares about video, which means we should all care about video too. And Google owns YouTube. So most of you probably knew that, but if you didn't know it, it really, they care a lot about boosting things that they own. And when they own YouTube, which is, you know, completely a video platform, it's something that they really care about sharing, and it will help increase your search engine optimization. So video is a traffic generating machine. So the more video content that you are adding to YouTube and adding to your website, it is on the back end boosting your website up in the rankings. And another thing, or another reason why it helps with your SEO, is that video will keep people on your website longer. So that like quick bounce rate, if they go to your website and then they go to another page deciding that they don't want to view it, that could, you know, definitely the time they're there on your page is going to be extended because they're watching, you know, a 3-minute video you put together on albums that you provide, or you're giving them information on what their session might look like, or some behind the scenes of your studio. So just some different ways that you can get people to stay on your website while also, you know, really serving them. And it's not like you're just putting fluff on your website. These are all valuable things that your clients care about. And the good news about that is that clients and other people in your industry are going to be more likely to link to your videos and share that content because it's really shareable, it's really easy to consume, and it's just a fun way to set yourself apart. And so yeah, video, the last thing I had was video helps improve the value of your search engine optimization. So, you know, you're not just loading fluff onto your website, you are really creating valuable, useful content. When people come and want to look for a photographer, they get to see your pretty face, they get to see you in action, and they get to hear your voice, they get to see your personality, and it just is going to make people that much more excited about working with you. Another stat, I'm not a huge statistics person, but they are kind of fascinating when it comes to video. HubSpot did a study, and it said shoppers are twice as likely to make a purchase after viewing a video than they are without that engaging content. So it's a great statistic, and it definitely will help you increase your SEO by getting more eyes on your site, and then it will help you to convert the people who get to your website. So I know so much of what the copy you put on your website and you know, sharing that information through word, the written word, is to convince the people who visit your website to actually hire you or actually purchase your services. And video does that as well. So I really like it. I'm such a video nerd. Like, I could talk about this stuff all day, but I want to kind of go in here in a second a little bit more about how to create your films, because I know we have a few questions popping up about that. Let's see. So in addition to your own website, I encourage you to add all of your videos to YouTube and Vimeo. Most importantly, YouTube. Vimeo comes with kind of a price, depending on how much content you want to upload. So I do think if you're crafting films that you are sharing with clients, it's a nice, pretty way to put videos on your website, but YouTube is the one that's going to be more valuable for your SEO. And then it's just, you know, more links with your video, more links with your website, and more eyes on your message. And with those, I would definitely encourage you to kind of keyword your videos. So I'm sure you guys have talked a little bit about keywording for blog posts. I know that's probably the most common place I've heard it, or even keywording for a landing page through the copy that you're utilizing. And so when you're setting up your videos in YouTube, you want to make sure you have a target keyword. I just put one up on my website about adding logos, text, and graphics in Premiere Pro to videos. And I did a ton of research on the front end to figure out what keyword I wanted to target for that YouTube video. And if you want a tool to do keyword research for YouTube videos, there's one called TubeBuddy. It's pretty cheap. So if you're gonna do a bunch of YouTube content, I think that it's totally worth it. Okay. So now that you know more about why you should be using video and where you should be posting, let's talk about creating the videos. So I know I've got a couple of questions on here about iPhones and GoPros, and done better than perfect. Yeah, I like that. Okay. So this information can be used for creating videos for your business. And if you are a photographer who's interested in learning how to craft and edit your own films, whether for you or for clients, you can use a lot of this information for business or personal. And if you do want to potentially add video as a service within your business, definitely hop over and check out that shelearnsvideo.com, where most of the content there is targeted at photographers who are looking to venture into the video side. And I was telling Keely before we hopped on the call, I'm really passionate about encouraging female photographers to do this, because I think a lot of times guys get really into the gear and they just get too in depth. Whereas women, at least myself, I have a toddler, she's 3. I don't have time to watch like a 25-minute YouTube video on how to set up lights. Like, I just want to know what lights to order and I just want to know how to use them. So if you want short and sweet content on how to make videos, go check that out. I also have a guide on how to add video to your business if you join my email list. So super easy there. I just figured I'd throw that in kind of in the middle for you guys. So when you're crafting your own films, I really encourage you to use the camera you already have or the camera you have with you. So sometimes that's my iPhone. We were just in North Carolina last week. I didn't even take my big camera and I shot all video on my iPhone. I made a family film for us when we went to Disney. Again, everything shot on my iPhone. So I do think that you can create great content personally and for some professional needs with your iPhone or a GoPro. Sorry, Keely, I'm hopping to the comments already, but I wanted to kind of put it in where it fits in. They purchased a GoPro with the intent of making short video marketing pieces for TikTok. Ooh, I like that. Yeah, I have started to dabble in TikTok, but then I got a little afraid of it because I didn't know what was going on with China. So I know I'm aging myself, Keely.
No, I'm just laughing. I actually got, I got 2 clients from TikTok, even though I haven't posted since March. So that's
awesome. I've heard of a lot of people connecting through it. So, you know, if you want to, and you feel like you can find a good way to make it work for you, I think that, you know, it's I've kind of been trying to figure out in my own space how it's going to best be used for educating and encouraging people rather than just like me learning how to do dance moves. But anyway, so yeah, I think, you know, a GoPro can definitely be utilized. They can create beautiful videos, especially if you're somebody who maybe you shoot like at the beach a lot and you're a little bit more worried about the elements. That can be something that can be useful there. And, you know, even your DSLR, obviously, or your mirrorless camera, those are going to be great tools for you. If you already have one, which I think most people in here are a photographer, you've already got like tool number one. So use what you have, even if it's your computer, to do screen captures and educate people that way, or go live with the camera you have on your computer. I think done and out there in the world is going to be much better than making it perfect, whether, you know, no matter what kind of level you're on, whether you're doing it for educating your clients or doing it as a service.
Absolutely. And as a quick side note, I think that kind of goes with everything. I know that you were talking about, you know, the best camera is the one that you have with you. It kind of ties along with social media. The best social media is the one that you're most comfortable with now. You know, nail that, keep going. And for video, same thing with copy, same thing with photo. Done is better than perfect. Absolutely.
I totally agree. And I think that there are, like I said, I'm going to get in here in a second on like reasons when you should hire someone to do it for you, and then other reasons when I think you should do it on your own. Another tool I will say is that if you don't already have a camera, get some sort of camera, whether it's your iPhone or a GoPro or your DSLR. I do think quality audio makes a huge difference. So there's a variety of different tools that you can utilize. If you are shooting with a DSLR, this is, it's a Rode Video Mic Pro, and it just goes right on the hot shoe and then plugs into your camera. And almost all the YouTube videos I do, I utilize this little buddy, and really I don't have to clean up the video or the audio like at all. So it captures really great audio. I use this on wedding days. It's a great microphone. They do have another version that's cheaper. I want to say this one's maybe like $150. I have a video on my website about audio gear, but this is a little bit, this is a windshield. So if it's windy outside, this is smaller. And again, just sits right on top of your camera, plugs into the side. The audio you're going to get from your camera is fine. So, you know, again, done is better than perfect. But I do think these make a huge difference in the ability for people to watch and kind of rewatch and share your videos. Because how many of you have ever gone to YouTube and the video is like really loud and screechy? You want to turn it off immediately. You don't even care what they have to say. Whereas if they don't look perfect or the lighting's a little bad, as long as you can hear what they are saying and the content is valuable, you're going to keep watching. Like, I've watched plenty of, you know, people overseas making these little videos on YouTube, and, you know, I can't even see their face, but I can hear them clearly, and that's the point. So I think it all depends on kind of what you need. They also have a Rode microphone for your iPhone, and it's what's called a lavalier mic. It clips on to your lapel, and you can record directly on your iPhone. So I link that as well. It's probably in, if you go onto my website, I've got some gear information on there too. So you can check that out if you're looking for audio gear, but any Rode microphone is gonna be one that'll serve you really well. And then a tripod, that's something I recommend. I will say, if you're shooting with your iPhone, they have these, you know, the little like iPhone clip things. You can screw that right on top of a light stand and record yourself. So that works really well. A monopod can be useful if you're looking to get into video work as a service. I will say, if you're shooting on a tripod and you're looking to do, you know, some video work where maybe you're panning or showing the gear that you have or showing a beautiful display of albums, these video heads, they're called fluid heads. Those are really nice. They're more expensive, but if you've already got a nice tripod, then you could add one of these on top of it, and it could help you depending on kind of what what kind of work you're looking to do and what kind of film you're looking to make. And then all of you know lights. You want to make sure you're in some pretty soft, maybe natural light, or if you're like me and don't have the best natural light in your office, you can create it or, you know, go out and purchase. I have these like LED video panels that I use that I really like. And so that's something you can utilize. But if you're just starting out with making videos, you know, go outside or stand in front of a really nice window and you've got your pretty light. And then editing software. If you are going to start putting together videos where you want to add in different clips, iMovie is a great tool. If you've already got a Mac, it's on your computer already. And then if you don't have a Mac, the other one that I've been recommending to people is called DaVinci Resolve. And it is a free tool. And you can also upgrade to a paid version, but I would definitely start with the free one. Download it, use it, learn the ins and outs of it. Because I have some friends who are filmmakers and they use the free version and, you know, they're making professional films for people. So you don't necessarily have to be paying for Premiere Pro or Final Cut Pro. Those are probably the two most popular paid softwares. I use Premiere mainly because I was already familiar with all the Adobe products and the filmmakers I learned from were using it. So, you know, it kind of depends on what your needs are and how serious you want to take the video side. But I say free is the way to go if you're just starting out. And then again, you know, think about your message for these videos. I guess I should wrap it up by saying that's really all you need. So you need a camera. If you want to get some sort of microphone, great. Some way to stabilize your camera or hold it with like a tripod or, you know, one of the iPhone mounts, and then great lights and something to edit it all together with. So that's pretty much it to start out with. And then if you are looking to get into more client work with video down the line, and you want to add it as a service in your business, I think, you know, audio gear, extra batteries, you are probably going to want to get some fast SD cards if you are shooting on a DSLR or a mirrorless camera. So I use these SanDisk Extreme Pro. That's what they look like. And you just want to make sure that they have a pretty fast write speed. On here, it shows the read speed, but there is also this like V30. When I did all this back-end research, I found out that was important. So SanDisk Extreme Pros, those are good ones. They won't let you down. And it does take up more space on your camera. So for lack of a better term, you're just basically taking a bunch of frames in each video. So think of it as just shooting a ton of still images, and that's why it's taking up more space on your memory cards. So you wanna have some larger memory cards that are fast if you are making videos on your mirrorless or DSLR. And that's it. So then kind of the next thing I wanted to say is just think about your message depending on what you're trying to communicate. And for every video you want to make, I really encourage you to create some sort of script or shot list. And I'll go into that a little bit more in just a moment. But think about who you want to serve and who your target is for every single video that you're doing. Which, you know, when you think about it from a copy perspective, you're thinking about that with every page you write on your website. You know, who do you want to land on this page? Who do you want to convert from this page? So you're kind of using that same tactic to then create a video. And just get started. The more you share and create, the easier it gets. I'm not gonna lie, I still get a little nervous every time before I have to get on the camera or I have to do an Insta story, mainly probably because I'm worried about like a 3-year-old running at every moment. But the more you do it, the easier it gets. And if you want to start expanding into your photography services or your photography services into filmmaking and video work, then there's a little bit more that goes into it. But I really hope that this will help you to get started with making your own videos. And then just a couple more things. If you are going to outsource your video work, I think that you should use this for, I'm a little warm in here, maybe more complicated projects. So especially more complicated editing projects. When you're first starting out, the editing I think is the most overwhelming. You're like, I can use my camera and I can set up a light and talk on camera. But when you're trying to splice it all together and add in music and maybe like a logo at the beginning or end, those are times that you might want to outsource the video work. And I think that these can be great for, you know, about pages on your website, product launches, or if you're creating a course. So sometimes photographers will do education where they make a course. I think that hiring somebody to come in, shoot the video, edit the video is gonna take so much off your plate and it'll really take that video to the next level. Basically, I like to think of it as outsourcing for anything. So anytime you would rather pay someone than spend your time either learning how to do it or the time and the money to shoot and edit it on your own, if that makes sense. So I do a lot of video work for other photographers who want an intro video for their about page, or maybe they're looking to change. I have a photographer next week. She shoots weddings, but she really wants to get into branding. So she's creating this video around her like brand launch. And, you know, she's outsourcing all the video work, which totally makes sense because it's just not something that she has time to learn on her own or invest for this one project. And then let's see, creating a script. I did briefly touch on this, but I do think that it's a place I would maybe encourage you to seek out some assistance or a second opinion. I think we're all capable of envisioning what we want the message of the video to be, but making sure it sounds on brand and will land with your clients is super important. So sometimes this is just me talking to, you know, my husband who knows me really well and my business, but, you know, isn't super interested in perhaps buying my product, but he can at least give me feedback on, okay, that does sound like you, or it sounds like you're kind of trying to be somebody you're not. Or you can seek out someone like a copywriter who can help you really hone in on what you're looking for. And I think that's a good opportunity when you're looking to do something a bit bigger and a bit more robust, whether it's like a course or an intro video or a client experience video or some sort of product launch. And then shot list. So a lot of people say storyboarding for videos, whereas maybe it's just because I'm a photographer and because I'm a one lady show, I know in my mind what I want the shot to look like. So I don't necessarily need to draw it out. But some people, that's the way their mind works. They want to draw out kind of where they want to place people in the scene or what they want themselves to look like with each shot. I just mainly make shot lists. And before I'm done with the video, I just, you know, check through, make sure the one I did on my gear, I just made a list of every single piece of gear I had, what I wanted to say about it. And then I kind of spliced it all together at the end. So just a good thing to have in mind whenever you're doing this. I think that in the beginning, it can be easy to think, okay, I'm gonna go make a video, and then you get everything set up and you're like, okay, wait, what did I even want to say? So taking the time to sit down, write it all out, and then you can kind of either read off of it or reference it when you need it. And sometimes I do like a tight formal script. If you are going to have a voiceover, I have a video on my website I just did for an event planner, and she was a little bit nervous about being on camera. So what we did was we just shot kind of behind the scenes of her working, and then her voiceover was played throughout the video. So she just held the script, read it straight beginning to end, and then we overlaid that audio with her her work. So, you know, depending on the kind of film you're making, sometimes the script can be really nice. And yeah, shot list, sharing your films on social. I think that's one of the last things I've got, but YouTube, obviously, you know, any type of video you can make and put on YouTube is just going to help for your SEO. You can put lots of information in the description. So, you know, definitely link people back to your website. Vimeo is really nice for client facing and delivery with videos. Loom, as I said, is a nice tool for kind of more like a low key video, just a quick snippet. The thing I also didn't mention about Loom is you can be on screen talking to your client while you're walking them through your, you know, website or your client delivery for their images, or you can just choose to have like your logo up or something like that. So you don't have to be on camera with Loom if you don't want to. And then yeah, IGTV, I think Instagram. So from everything I've studied is that the more you use all the different services they have, the better, like the more they will push your content up. So as long as you're like posting on the feed, posting in stories and using IGTV, that's kind of like, although as I said this morning, I think they added something new. So it's always changing, but trying to use every element within a social media platform is definitely going to help boost your exposure. Facebook Lives, and then if you do upload video content to Facebook, I encourage you to do it natively, which means you kind of drag and drop the video onto Facebook when you're uploading it. Don't just use like the YouTube link because it won't autoplay, and that autoplay is going to really grip people in. As soon as they see it, they're going to want to stop and watch it and learn more. So rather than them having to click the link to your YouTube page and go there to watch it, which probably isn't going to happen. Yeah. And so other than that, next week I'm doing a video week on my Instagram page. It's just at Kelly White Photography, and it's Kelly with an I. So Kelly with an I, white like the color photography. And I'm going to be sharing information every day next week on different gear you should utilize, how to edit your films, even if you're making films just for your own family, how I would encourage you to do that, how to share them. So kind of a lot of this information, but maybe a little more targeted to photographers. So if you are one, definitely check me out there. And then shelearnsvideo.com, got a ton of resources over there. Yeah. And so let me see. Now we got a bunch of questions. Sorry, I thought it was going to be about 30 minutes. I went a little long.
You are totally fine, Kelly. I think you really shared a lot of really great information. So thank you.
Good.
I'm excited for this Q&A.
Okay. So, okay. Buongiorno or video reply app? I am not. Okay, let me actually start at the top. GoPro. Mom and business owners. Yeah, I mean, branding for mom business owners, whoever said that, you could do some awesome stuff with video as well. Even if you're just doing short little clips and adding it on as like an upsell or a bonus, you know, I think that's a great place to start. I've shown landscape. I want to specialize in family and children. You know, I really think family films are kind of the next thing. I know I'm kind of one of the only people in my area who offers them, but I think if you look back in like 5 to 10 years, there's going to be a ton of female filmmakers making family films. And if you want to learn how to do it now, it's the time. GoPro with the intent of making video marketing pieces. I think that's a great idea. I do think it probably depends on what kind of GoPro you have, depending on the view. I will say some of those GoPros, the angle's just super wide and you may not necessarily want to put your face in front of it all the time, but some of them have different angles. I have the GoPro Hero 6 and I use it a lot if we're like outside or at the park with my daughter or some like the beach. I meant to take it to the beach and actually forgot it, but that's a great place to take it. But I do think you can use it. You know, it's TikTok. It's one of those things that like, that's so informal. It does not need to be fancy. I do think it's probably easier to make it with your phone for TikTok just from an editing perspective, but if anybody knows any different, let me know. I know it's easy to like put it into TikTok, like film it directly from your phone. Yeah. Okay. So yeah, use the GoPro for something different maybe and phone for TikTok. Done's better than professional. I do, when it comes to like serving your clients with content, putting content on your blogs, I think that professional is going to be really well served in those times that you want, like, on your landing page, maybe you want video content immediately. I think that should be maybe higher end content. I think on your about page, you're going to want something that's a little bit more impactful, I think. And just making sure that you know what you're doing, because it's going to, if it's on your about page, it's really reflecting who you are and what your business brand is. And you don't want to have, like, if you're a high-end wedding photographer, you don't want to have, C-level video on there, because it's just not going to connect. Buongiorno and video reply. I'm not, but just from the name of video reply, it sounds like it might be similar to Loom.
It's called Buongiorno. And it's, if somebody contacts you, you can just record, "Hey, Nancy, so great to you reaching out for me. I'm so happy that we can connect on this date," or whatever. And so it would send an email out to them and they click on it and it goes to a video. And I had a realtor that I sent one to, and she watched it 7 times.
Wow.
So I don't know whether she was showing people, "Hey, we need to use this." So it really can create a buzz, and it's very much more connecting than just,
yes,
email,
so yes, it sounds like it's really similar to Loom, because that's kind of how I've used that tool. So yeah, keep doing it. I'll have to check it out though. It's one of those things that, like, I feel like new tools, every day somebody tells me about some new tool that I've never heard of before. So I'll definitely give it a look, because it sounds fun. And, anytime you can make an impact like that, it sets you apart. You know, if they're emailing 5 photographers and you send them back a custom video, they are going to want to book you, because you didn't send some, like, form email, or, not being nearly as personal as a video would be, and taking the time. I think just seeing that somebody took 5 minutes out of their day to respond personally is just really cool.
They have a free for a while, I think. I've never paid for it, but free trial. Yeah.
And Loom, I think Loom's always free. There's probably paid features, as there is with, like, everything. But I, like I said, I don't totally know the ins and outs of that other one, so I'll check that out. Thanks for sharing. And then iPhone 10 Plus, better than earlier versions. Yeah, I just got the 11 Pro Max when we went to Disney, because I really wanted kind of the upgraded camera. I do think 10 and beyond is, you're doing just fine. I think you've got everything you need. But I mean, it, like, they shoot like 60 frames a second, 4K. I mean, it's stuff that some of your DSLRs don't even do. So I think that your iPhone can be a really great tool for anybody looking to make films, especially personal films, just because they're so easy to have in your pocket. Suggested length of video. So I really think suggested length of video is going to depend on what the content is. I think if it's like an intro video about your business, like short, sweet, this is my face, this is me using a camera, this are some happy clients. I've heard 20 seconds is about all you get for people. I will say on YouTube, everybody says that no matter how long the video is, people are only going to probably watch like a third of it. I don't know how true that is, but those are kind of the statistics I've heard thrown around. So I think that making it long enough to convey your message without a bunch of fluff is the key. That's kind of where I would leave it, is, and it just goes back to having a script or a storyboard or a shot list and making sure that it's valuable from, the beginning to the end. Do you have to be really close for audio? So it depends on the mic you have, I think. The closer you are to the microphone, the better quality audio it's going to be. So for weddings, like, I'll clip a lavalier mic on the groom and just put it in his pocket, because there's no way at the back of a church this microphone with all the, like, marble floors and columns is going to pick up quality audio. But if you're sitting in a small room with carpets, you know, where it's not a bunch of hard surfaces and it's just you talking to the camera, this works great. So I think it really just depends on what type of video you're making. And a lot of times there might be a few different tools you need for different, different types of audio that you want to record. Ooh, free music source. This is one I didn't, I almost went into that. Let me see. Skipped one. Okay. What would be a fast write speed? So to be honest, I wrote a like full article on gear on my website, shelearnsvideo.com. There's only a few blog posts up right now because I'm just kind of like launching this thing. So go to that, go to the gear page, and it talks a lot about what you should be looking for on the cards. But I do know there's like a, this 10 that's in a little circle, the V30, those are important. So if you're looking it up, look for that. But the SD Extreme Pros are going to be good for what you need. If you're going to be shooting a lot of like 4K video, then there are some, I think, additional features you can get in an SD card. But for most of us, you know, 1080p is going to be plenty. And sorry if that's like super nerd speak as far as video goes, but what would be a fast write speed? Are there slideshow videos effective for your website? I mean, the thing is, it's a video. So I think if you're gonna start somewhere, it's a great place to start. If it's in a video content, something you can put on YouTube, something you can add audio to, it's better than nothing right now. So I would say definitely if you're really intimidated by being on camera or like interviewing clients on camera for testimonials, maybe put together just a slideshow with behind the scenes from a session of different images and, you know, utilize that. Just make sure they're your same branded high quality images that you produce and share those in a video format. I think that's a great idea. Suggestion for free music. So I do have again, not to like continuously harp on this, but this was another common question I was getting to be from people. And so if you go to my website, I've got a whole article on where to find free and paid music, but like where you should be getting it. I will say, do not put just a downloaded song off iTunes on your video, or you could be in really big trouble. They require you to pay for them from artist, especially if you're a business owner, you shouldn't be doing that. But YouTube has a, I think it's YouTube Studio. They have a resource that's full of free music for that will serve most of your needs. If you're looking to get into making films for clients or for families, newborns, stuff like that, I do tend to like kind of more moodier songs, sometimes with lyrics. And the website I use is called Soundstripe. Soundstripe.com. It's super affordable. I want to say it's like $120 something for the whole year. And you can download all their music as many times as you want. They've got a lot of great options. Another one is Music Bed. And it, I would say, unless you're getting into like doing a lot of wedding films or films where you're going to be charging in the like thousands of dollars, I probably wouldn't pay for it. It's just, it's more like, $80-$90 a month for that level of using that level of service. So yeah, YouTube Studio, and then iMovie. If you're in iMovie, they have like a library of free songs that you can check out there. Let's see. Can you give a range of what's usually charged for someone to create promo videos for someone's product? That's tough. I mean, I think in a way, to me, that's kind of the question of like, how much is a photographer? Because it can be really broad depending on what you need. You know, how long is the shoot going to be? How many locations are we going to be shooting at? How, you know, how many days are we going to be shooting? So I think a lot of it comes into what you're looking for. I charge $850 for 2 hours, one location. It's all, we do three small, like under a minute films for kind of small business owners. You can go to my website and see my package that I do. So really that's kind of the best advice I can give. I think that it's one of those things you just kind of have to explore. And I know Keely's kind of one of the best people at this, but what's it going to cost you to make this video and then, you know, charge appropriately for it? You know, it takes a lot of editing to do video opposed to photo in the beginning, especially. So do not, if you're going to start doing video for clients, don't sell yourself short. Don't do too much of this for free because it takes a lot of time. So I hope that's helpful. If it's not, then ask me something else. YouTube videos, how to create a teleprompter using your iPad. Ooh, yes. I love that. Yes, that's a great idea. You can also, there's an app you can download on your laptop. You can do it with that. But yes, I've used that for some clients. So that's a great point from Karen. And then you have to have paid YouTube account if you don't want suggestions for other videos. Is that a do you or is that a statement? I don't know. From Nancy. If it's a do you, I would think yes, because YouTube just sends people what they want to send people. I think that if you have a YouTube channel and you're producing consistent content, you can put end cards or end screens, which are basically like suggestions to subscribe to your channel or view this video within your video. But yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, it's kind of like another social media where, you know, you don't own the platform. So that's why I think putting stuff on your own website is really important, because there you do own the platform. You know, crafting like an email list, like they say all the time, just to send people kind of back to what you're doing is important. But yeah, YouTube, there are pros and cons, and there are a lot of different like paid tools that you can use. 8+, looking for an excuse to, yeah, and write that thing off, Karen. Get yourself a 11 Pro. Do it, girlfriend. Show me all the pretty videos you make with it. So yeah, okay. Well, Keely, do you have any questions? Am I rambling?
No, that was awesome. Before you go though, I would love for you to share again the course that you have coming up next week, as well as where we can find you.
Yes. Okay. So you can find me at my business page is kellywhitephotography.com. She learns video, just like it sounds.com is my new kind of educational platform. I have an email list there with an opt-in for if you want to add video to your business. It's a great little like 10-page PDF on how to do that. And then next week on my Instagram page, it's at Kelly White Photography. I'm going to be doing what I'm going to call Video Week, where each day I'm going to go live on Instagram and share different tips about gear and about editing, about, you know, music, kind of everything we talked about tonight. But I'm just going to be getting on there and kind of diving deep into a topic on each day. And then I think the following week, as long as everything's ready, I have a Video Basics for Photographers course that I've put together. And I'll be launching that soon as well. So I would love for you guys to stay connected. If you make videos, tag me and share. I'll share them. I'll get really excited. Just so thankful, Keely, for you allowing me this opportunity to chat with everyone. And I hope you guys got something out of it. So
thank you so much, Kelly. And if you guys want to rewatch this, I am going to post the recording in the group. And if you have any additional questions for Kelly or want to join her course coming up, you know where to find her, shelearnsvideo.com or at Kelly White Photography. So thank you, Kelly, again, so much. I know I learned so much. I think this is for everyone. The content you shared today was so valuable. So thank you so much.
Awesome. Well, thank you guys. Stay in touch. I hope to see some of you creating videos down the road.
Thank you. Very good.
Thank you.